Hey, what's up, everybody? Zulus here, and today I'm going to be looking at which side of transfer paper do you use if you're doing dye sublimation. And so I'm using an Epson SureColor F170, which is a dye sublimation printer, and then I'm also using the recommended DS transfer multi-use paper, and you can see the number that I have right there, S450361, and it's 8.5 by 11 inch paper. So some confusion on which side you should use. So when you open this paper up, there's two different sides. Normally with sublimation, you can feel sort of a stickier side, and that's the side you normally print on, but these don't really feel any different. So there's kind of an off-white, which we called off-white, and then there's a white, which is a brighter white, and you can definitely see the difference here in them too. So we'll go ahead and print on each side of these and then see which one works better. We'll check out the results. So when it goes through the printer, it will pull it up and then it'll print on the other side. So you'd want to have these face down, like so. So we'll do that. And we'll go ahead and print out two of the same design and press them on a polyester shirt and see what the results yield. All right, so we've got a small design printing out on both of these. We got the off-white one done already, and wait for the brighter white one to come out. I swear this is nowhere on the packaging either, so it was a trial and error. I mean, I had done this originally, and yeah, that's kind of the result that I got. And so this is the white one. Let's print it up, whatever. So you can see the difference in the colors, just as we had them originally. There's the white, and then the sort of off-white one. All right, so we'll go ahead and tear or perforate these designs. I mean, just tear like this, tear it out, so that it doesn't leave lines in the polyester. We do print it, even though I'm just using a beater shirt that I've already done a bunch on, and you can kind of see the lines. If you do press them wrong, you'll get lines. So you gotta make sure you eliminate those, and the best way to do that is to perforate around the edges. And so we'll go and tear out. We'll do the off-white first on the front of the shirt, and then I'll do the white on the back. All right, so we've got our design perforated. It's all cut out, ready to go. I'm just gonna put a Teflon sheet on top of this. You wanna make sure your Teflon sheet covers this entirely, because otherwise you'll get creases. So we'll go ahead and slap this baby on here like that. Make sure it's all the way over the surface of it. It doesn't really matter what my design is. This is a beater shirt anyways, but if you're doing this professionally, you're gonna wanna tape it down and everything. So yeah, so we'll go like that. Your heat settings, 200 Celsius or around 385 Fahrenheit. This machine's in Celsius. And then about 45 seconds. So let's go ahead and press this and see what we get with the off-white. All right, my timer didn't click, so I lost about 5 seconds. So we're gonna pull this up now. And let's see what we got here. And there it was. Can see the off-white transferred through, and it did leave a little bit of scarring around. That means I need to adjust my pad on the bottom and the pressure of it actually to get rid of those, but that is what it looks like. So let's do the back now. And 1 sec. Okay, so I made the executive decision here to put this white one right next to the other one so we could see the comparisons easy. So we'll just put that right there next to the other one so you can see the layout. This is the front of the shirt, not the back. And we'll go ahead and adjust my my pressure a little bit too, so see if we can get this right and get rid of those creases. All right, so we've got the white side down, the pad underneath, the timer set correctly. We will put a piece of paper over top of this so it doesn't bleed. And that's kind of it. And let's go ahead and see if I can stick this on here and hold the phone at the same time. Didn't do a very good job of that. And that's still in the same place. It'll be right next to that one. And let's go ahead and press this baby. I loosened up the tension a little bit, by the way, to try to get rid of those rigid lines. Hey, man, this is hard to do with polyester, man. I always struggle with this. So we shall see. All right, I cut out a little bit the timer. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's see what we got here. We'll pull off the paper. Pull off the design. And yeah, it definitely appears to be the lighter side is the better to print on. And we'll get these out of here and check it out. All right, so I was trying to get a little better light, and the white side actually is a little bit more vibrant. I don't know if you can see the difference than the side that's kind of an off-white, but they both do print through. After I was doing mouse pads and I actually messed up, and that's kind of when I realized that what Epson support told me was wrong. In fact, it is not the off-white side, although it does work. It's actually the white side, and the interesting thing is after you press this, the paper actually turns the color of the off-white side, which makes me think that the chemicals are transferring through. But like I said, they both go through, and it's really not that noticeable. You really have to focus in on it to actually see the color difference, and it's very slight, but you do get better colors if you print on the white side of the paper. So, and you can see there's the white and there's the off-white. So I was wrong in my original video because I was misled by Epson support. And you know what, there's a number of different papers that you can use. Normally you can feel the sticky side on the paper, and that's normally the side that you'd want to print on. In this case, neither side's really sticky. And yeah, there's no instructions on the packaging or anything. So I believe it is the white side that you're supposed to print on, just based on these results. And like I said, it's really hard to tell, even in pretty good lighting. I mean, I have overhead lighting and bright and everything. So yeah, that's what we got. So I hope this helped people out. I know it's been a learning experience for me, that's for sure. And these answers are hard to find when you dig around. So you know what? Thanks for everyone that's commented and stuff like that. Told me that it was in fact the white side. And there's been several comments about it, and it inspired me to make another video. And yeah, as always, I hope you enjoyed this, and peace out. Exulas!